It's a fabulous set of revelations. You know, I'm absolutely delighted by it. But, you know, it also is a Sisyphean task. I think one of the things that hasn't come out, and I think people need to start thinking about this, and Eva Jolie touched on this earlier, is the issue of blowback into our own society. So this is a story with two sides. One side is the sort of traditional story pointing fingers at corrupt people in Africa, and sure, there's lots of corruption going on there. The other side of the story is us in the West receiving this money, handling this money, aiding and abetting these crimes that are going on. And it's fantastic that we've seen so much attention to the enablers, the intermediaries, the consulting firms, the big four accounting firms, the bankers, who are actively soliciting this money, trying to get this money out. They're helping it out. They're helping capital flight, helping the draining and the looting of Africa. But if we're going to do something about this, if we're going to get serious about this, it's quite difficult. In the UK, for example, which is a central player in most of these games, it is one of the most important players in the world of offshore tax havens. There is this kind of sort of Janus-faced approach, this double approach. On the one hand, you know, we don't like looting African countries and we feel bad about it and we don't like aiding and abetting corruption. But on the other hand, we see all this money coming in from poorer countries and we say, well, we like the money. And that's a kind of, you know, do we like it? Do we not like it? It's a recipe for inaction.